Hi everyone, welcome back. In this video, I'm going to show you how to allocate one or more resources to tasks in the Angular Gantt chart component based on the task requirement. First, I open my existing application, where I have installed the Angular Gantt package, and all the modules of the Gantt chart are configured in the app module page. In the app component HTML page, I have added the basic rendering code of the Gantt chart. In the data.ts file, I define the hierarchical object, project new data, with a collection of tasks. I added fields like task ID, task name, and so on to a single task. I also added the subtasks field to define child tasks. I added other tasks, as well, with appropriate parent and subtasks. In the app component class, I have assigned that hierarchical object to the variable data. In the app component HTML page, I assigned that data object to the datasource property of the Gantt chart component. You can refer to my Angular Gantt chart getting started video to learn more about configuring the component. I've shared a link to it in the card above and the description below. Let me run this application. See here, the left pane has a tree grid with hierarchical data, and the right pane has a chart with a project timeline. Next, I'll show you how to allocate resources to the Gantt chart. Resources are JSON objects that contain an ID, name, unit, and a group of resources. Here, the ID field is used to assign the resource to the task. The name field is used to map the resource names. The unit field is used to indicate the amount of work a resource needs to do in a day. And the group field is used to group the tasks assigned to that specific resource into the category. In the data.ts file, I have added the object editing resources, which has fields like resource ID and resource name. Notice the object project new data contains a collection of resource IDs and resource unit in each task. When the unit is not specified, the amount of work done will be considered 100% by default. So, this collection needs to be mapped to the Gantt chart control using the resources property. Open the app component class and import the editing resources object from the data.ts file. I assign it to the variable resources. In the task settings, map the assigned resources of the task using the resource info field. Assign this variable to the resources property of the component. Lastly, define the object resource fields and map the resource ID from the data source to the ID property, and the resource name to the name property. Assign this object to the resource fields property of the Gantt component. Then, add the column to show the resource details from the data source, and map the assigned resources of the task using the field and header text properties. Check the Gantt chart. The resource column is shown in the Gantt tree grid, and it displays the resource names assigned to the task. Let's see how to show resource labels on the Gantt chart using the label settings property. In the app component class, declare an object variable label options and assign the resources field to the right label option. Then assign this label options variable to the label settings property. Looking at it, the resources are shown in the label on the right side of the taskbar. Next, I will show you how to add or edit the resources assigned to the task. I open the app module page, import the edit service from the EJ2 Angular Gantt package, and inject it into the provider's array of the NG module. In the app component class, I add the variable edit options of type object and the allow editing property. I set its value to true. Then I assign this variable to the edit settings property of the Gantt chart. Checking now, when I double-click the tree grid cell in the resources column, the dropdown is shown, and I can assign more or remove the existing resources. When I double-click the taskbar, the dialog will pop out. Under the resources tab, I can add or remove the resources. I can also edit the units. To edit the resources in the tree grid dialog, I include the mode property and set its value to dialog. When I double-click the Resources column data, the dialog will be shown, and I can edit the details under the Resources tab. To add the new task with resource details, I enable the Allow Adding property in the Edit options. To show this option on the toolbar, I open the App Module page, import the module, Toolbar Service, from the EJ2 Angular Gantt package, and inject it into the Providers array of the NG module. Then, in the App Component class, I include the Toolbar Options variable with the option Add. I assign this variable to the Toolbar property. Now, when I click the Add Toolbar button, the dialog pops out with the default value. I will fill in the necessary details under the General and Resources tabs. Next, I will show you how to visualize the list of tasks assigned to each resource in a hierarchical manner. I set the ViewType property to the Resource View option to achieve this. Looking now, you can visualize the list of tasks assigned to each resource hierarchically. A task with no resource assigned comes under the Unassigned Task category. What if a resource is assigned to two or more tasks scheduled on the same date? We call this overallocation. I enable the Show Overallocation property to highlight the overallocation date ranges with square brackets. As you can see, the overallocated tasks are highlighted in square brackets. Assume that the tree grid records are in a collapsed state. In such a case, we cannot visualize multiple tasks assigned to each resource. To overcome this, we can divide the taskbar for each resource by adding the Enable Multitaskbar property and setting its value to true. Then, I open App Component page and map the task name field from the data source to the task label property to show the taskbar label. Check this Gantt chart now. The taskbar is divided based on the tasks assigned to the resource. In this video, I have shown you how to allocate one or more resources to tasks in the Gantt chart. I also showed you the resource breakdown view and resource multi-task bar. You can download a working example of this from the GitHub link in the description for this video below. You can also see whether you're eligible for our community license, which will provide you with a free license key to use our products. Thank you for watching this video. If you found it useful, give it a like and subscribe to our channel.